Just like the end of an explosive fireworks show, Philippians 4 finishes this prison epistle with a great display of power and grand finale. Paul could have finished this letter with a woe is me or help me please, but instead, he continues his thought from chapter 3 to entreat this dear church to follow his example. And what example does he ask them to follow? To stand firm in the Lord, verse 1. To rejoice in the Lord, verse 4. Let your behavior of gentleness be a witness to those around you, verse 5. To be anxious for nothing, but in prayer for everything, verse 6. And if the mind needs to wander, Paul, in verse 8, gives us a godly thought garden to graze upon. He says, choose the pure things, the lovely things, the praiseworthy things, and the commendable things to set our minds on. But what I most want to draw your attention to, what I want to highlight the most from this chapter, is not the what to do's, but the most importantly, the how to do's. How can we do all these things that Paul lays out as an example? He says that it is the God of peace that will give us the peace of God, that we can do all things through Christ who strengthens us, verse 13. And in verse 19, that our God will supply all of our need. So, like Paul, may our situations of frustration, suffering, and even prison be a platform for that which displays an example of godliness with God dependency. And as Paul closes, I will close as well. May the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ be with your spirit. And remember, you are greatly loved. So go and greatly love.